American Revolution, the Americans built another fort called Fort Greene after the Daniel Greene, who was a Revolutionary War hero that lived in Savannah. Those two forts were too wooden and earthen and timbered forts that were not very strong. The War of 1812 with England, England invaded this country and actually invaded Washington, D.C. and burnt the capital. The Congress at that time decided they needed to build fortifications all up and down the East Coast to protect it. About 15, 25 years later, this fort was started. 1825, this fort was started. Robert E. Lee was just a graduate of West Point. He came down here and was one of the engineers involved in the early construction, digging the moats around the fort so that it would be on dry land. But by 1860, the Union Army only had, the American Army, because at that time it was two soldiers in the fort. It was, had been completed, but it had not been furnished with weapons. Abraham Lincoln had been elected president. There was talk of secession, and a group of Savannah soldiers from Savannah came down, took over the fort, ran those two Union Army soldiers out, and the Confederates took over the fort. Now, this was 2 months before the firing on Fort Sumter, when the Confederates were already up. As the fort, the South had not succeeded at that time, but they still had control of the fort. By the, early 1861, by the fall of 1861, the Union Army had landed 25,000 troops on Hilton Head, brought them over, under the cover of darkness. They had placed 11 cannon batteries in this tree line right behind us on Tybee. You can see the water tower in that area where the trees are. The 11 cannon batteries with 30 cannons, and they were all facing Fort Pulaski. They had done all this under the cover of darkness. The Confederates had done that. The cannons were there. On April the 10th, the Union general came over and requested the surrender. The Confederates refused. The next 36 hours, the bombardment of Fort Pulaski continued. The 5,200 shells were fired at the fort. If you look at the walls of the fort, you can see dimples where the there's a mark where the cannon fire actually hit the fort during the Civil War, during the siege of Fort Sumter. After the 36 hours of bombardment, by 2 o'clock that next afternoon, the Confederates surrendered. The wall had been breached. Now, as we move along, that large tree is blocking the discolored bridge from the bridge of another car. That's where the wall was breached, and the Confederates surrendered before the fort blew up. That's where the powder magazine was held, and they surrendered. The Confederates surrendered. The Union Army had the fort for the rest of the Civil War. It was a POW camp for prisoners, Confederate officers, prisoners who were officers, and prisoners who were Confederate politicians. Now you can see that's where the breach was, where the breach is a different color. During the summer of 1862, there was a New York regiment stationed in the fort. They lined up, got on in the parade formation. They were going to have a picture taken, a photograph made. That photograph was taken in the background when the baseball game being played. That is the first known photograph of a baseball game. It was taken right here in Fort Pulaski. Just on the other side of the fort, in 1736, John and Charles Wesley landed. If you're a Methodist, you may know who they are. John Wesley spent 19 months in Savannah. His brother Charles was over from Mexico. John was a minister at Christ Church Episcopal downtown Savannah. They left, went back to Europe, and there they formed the Methodist religion. They are the fathers of Methodism. And their only journey in the New World started and ended right here in Cotton. By 1880, the fort had been abandoned and overgrown. Mentioned earlier about the hurricane of 1881 that tore up everything behind the Coxboro Lighthouse, and the family had to flee to the stairwell over here in the fort for safety. They survived the hurricane because they were in that stairwell of the fort. The Lakekeeper's house was built up on top of the fort after that. But that family was the Martis family. George Martis was the lakekeeper. He had a 13-year-old daughter. About 2 years later, George Martis died and had his older son and the daughter went to El the daughter was Florence Martin. And you know who the waiting girl is in downtown Savannah? That's Florence Martin. She stands on River Street, memorialized in a sculpture, and she's waving at the ship. The legend is that she waved the ship for 40 years coming in and out of the port of Savannah. She had a boyfriend that left her, and he was going to come back and marry her, and he never came back, and she stayed there for 40 years waving, hoping he was on one of their ships. She told somebody that the reason she was waving is because she was born on that little island. There was nothing to do, so she just waved at the ship. But the statue downtown on River Street is by Felix DeWeldon. Felix DeWeldon also is the sculptor who did the Iwo Jima Memorial in Washington, D.C. So you get downtown River Street, you'll see her. See her waving her to the little dog beside her, and that's her first mother. She was born right here on Cox Drive.